the halachically that is the case, that they have to have a circumcision. In many cases, most that I can think of right now, they've all been circumcised. Mm-hmm. Not for religious reasons, but for hygienic reasons. Yeah. It's become far more fashionable, in which case there has to be, there's a ceremony in which there's a drop of blood that is taken from the area. But I must say, in my own case, it has to do with the individual. If that individual is frightened, I would not coerce him to do that. But usually it's the other way around. They want to do that. They want to identify, because this is, again, a free choice. See, Jews have a difficult time understanding why would this individual, man or woman, apparently sane and safe, why would they identify themselves with a fate and a faith that's pretty troublesome in history? I asked one person this usual, it's an old question that the rabbis in the Talmud asked in the first centuries. Do you know that we are a people subject to a great deal of persecution? And this person said to me, and I'll never forget him, he said, I certainly do. And yet you're making this decision. And his answer was, I would rather be counted among the persecuted than amongst the persecutors.
Yeah.
Remarkable.
Interesting, too, the way this is written, that so even with one of the first people who is Catherine Winninger,
mm-hmm.
And her last name now is Benheim, family she marries into is Moroccan.
Mm-hmm.
Moroccan, but you also have her parents talking about their daughter becoming a Jew.
Yes. It was very difficult for many people. And it's understandable that...
Well, you're rejecting your mother's religion, so to speak.
Yeah, but the point is it really is not a rejection. And I think that's very important to understand. First of all, we talk about Christians and Jews, or for that matter, Islamic people as well. These are people of the book. And there's a tremendous commonality. But we all speak different languages. What they have found in Judaism is not a rejection, but a deepening of their understanding of faith. What they tell me, what I really believe, is they enjoy the fact that I'm a teacher, and therefore that I am not infallible. They also enjoy the fact that there is no conception in Judaism of original sin, of some original stain which is almost inherited from Adam and Eve.
Mm-hmm.
And they appreciate the fact that in Judaism there is no such thing as original sin. If you sin, it's your own sin. And if you sin, whatever you consider that sin to be, you can do something about it. And it's not a question of waiting for somebody else to sacrifice himself. You've got to repair that. If I have hurt you, Connie, there's no substitute but my coming and apologizing and asking your forgiveness.
Two interesting, two people who are people who write about themselves is John, who becomes a rabbi.
Yes.
Rabbi Deborah Ornstein said to him, well, look, you're going through all of these learning. What, you can become a rabbi? And it suddenly dawned him, yeah, maybe it will answer some other problem or need that I have. And at 49, he became an ordained rabbi.
And is a fine rabbi.
Yeah.
I know him well. He's had a congregation that I knew well. And it should come less and less as a surprise. Again, because this is not a matter of DNA.
Mm-hmm.
I don't choose my DNA, but I choose my character, and I choose my vocation. And if I come into a tradition which honors the family as much as this does, which honors learning as much as this does, which recognizes that ethics is central to faith, why would I not want to identify with it?
Are you aware that at times for the Gentile, that it is, and even for the Jew, that they will look on the person who has become a Jew by choice with a questioning look. Why would you?
Yeah, but it's because they have a very little understanding or appreciation themselves of Judaism. So if you, as you said, take it for granted, but what is it you take for? You take nothing, you don't know. You have all kinds of notions that to be a Jew is to be intelligent, is to be, that's not true. And if you want verification, I will introduce you to many Jews who are not intelligent.
Wonderful woman here who has a voice that God has given her.
Yes.
Lorna Lembeck.
Mm-hmm.
She was not Jewish. She marries Harvey, and I can only say that I have heard her sing at a ceremony.
Mm-hmm.
It's a gift that brings you God into your home.
Right, but it's not a Jewish gift.
Yeah.
It's that gift, I didn't make that voice.
Yeah.
Voice is given. How she's going to use that voice?
Yeah.
Is she going to become a cantor? Or is she going to become a pop star? That's her choice.
And her husband said her voice became even more beautiful as she is singing the religious
songs. I won't argue with that, but first of all, it's her husband.
Now, I have to ask you about two things that you talk about in an essay. The strain of Ezra and the other.